Welcome back to 843 TV. We are now delighted to welcome the James Wedgeworth of the Wedgeworth Group. Couldn't be introduced any other way.
Thanks.
So, you know, it's an interesting time right now, and there's been a lot of stock market fluctuation. What impact does that have on the real estate market here?
You're giving me a hardball Markets, real estate markets don't like fluctuations. They don't like uncertainty. The worst thing you have is the market go down 600 points one day and up 7 the next, down 5 the next, and up 4 the next. What that tradition has done, people say, what's going on? So we've seen over the years that when you have fluctuations in the stock market, a lot of people just kind of back off real estate and say, we'll make a decision a little later.
They want to wait and see what happens.
They're trying to figure out what's causing these fluctuations, you know.
Interesting.
If it's just a normal market where it's up 10 points one day, down 8 the next, up 12 the next, nobody seems to notice it. But on those down days, everybody's glued to their TV and they're trying to figure out what's going on in the economy. And real estate markets just don't respond well to that, unfortunately.
Makes it a little more challenging for you all.
Yes.
But now we're in December, the holiday season. Is it true that it's a little more tough to sell during that time? How does the market flow in December?
Traditionally, December, from Hilton's point of view, and most markets in the United States, December is the slowest month year for real estate sales. We don't have as many people visiting the island in December, and a lot of the people live on the island in December go back to New Jersey,
right,
wherever they're from,
sure,
to visit their family. So traditionally, the slowest real estate month of the year for what we call pending sales is December. I've been here going on my 38th year, and it's been that way every year. I assume it would be that way this year. I wish it was. I'm still working. I don't take the month off. But that's usually the way the trend line works.
Well, speaking of the trend line, looking at historic data, when can we expect things to kind of get rolling again, when the sunshine starts peeking out a little more?
Traditionally, the markets are slow in after Thanksgiving,
okay,
and slow the first couple of weeks of January. Traditionally, our market heats up on what we call President's Weekend. I think it's like February the 14th, Valentine's Day, and you have a pretty strong market from Valentine's Day to Heritage Sunday, the Monday after Heritage. I used to tell people the real estate markets are in direct proportion to the azalea blooms.
We're from Alabama, so we know about the azalea trail.
We know a lot about the azalea trail.
We do.
So that varies, you know, obviously stock market affects it and things like that, but traditionally that's one of the strongest times of the year.
Understanding that the real estate market is such an emotional purchase and probably the largest purchase most people make, and how we're all so fixed to the news and what happens, do you think that the midterm elections had any effect on the real estate market?
It really did. I know it did, because I'm a numbers cruncher, and we look at these numbers weekly, you know, how many houses went under contract. And this October, we were going, what's going on? Because we had a really good first 6 months. A decent July and August, but then about October, we just noticed that not as many things aren't selling. I think it had to do with midterm elections. Now, normally what happens is people wait to see what happens, and as soon as what happens, it really doesn't matter what happens, it just happens. It doesn't matter Company A or Company B wins, so to speak, then the market picks up. This year, we noticed it did not pick up. And I think it was because of all the recounts, the Florida, the Georgia, and the just all kind of hatred and Kavanaugh problems and things like that. People don't like that environment, and we've seen so much of that. It's really hurt our market this fall, much more than I would have thought. So, I mean, we go through this every 2 years. It's not a big deal. But for some reason, it was a bigger deal this year. I really can't tell you exactly why. But I thought it just prolonged longer.
Like I said, there's so much uncertainty and people are not as
comfortable. People don't like.
That's right.
Stock market uncertainty. They don't like political uncertainty. They don't like economic uncertainty. And to be honest with you, they don't like weather uncertainty either.
Right.
You
know,
James, those are all things none of us can control. So there's always going to be uncertainty. So we can't let that worry us. But tell us about the price ranges. there's a wide range on Hilton Head and beyond. Is there a difference in how the different ranges are fluctuating?
The Bluffton market has not been affected as much as the Hilton Head market, mainly because the majority of the Bluffton market is lower price homes. Mm-hmm. Now we see even on Hilton Head, the lower price homes are selling. When I say lower price on Hilton, I'm talking below 500. From 500 to a million is a little sluggish. Over a million has been pretty slow. I don't know exactly why, but I've just noticed that from what's going on.
And real quick, before we wrap up, when January comes, people start thinking about their homes on the market. What are some quick spiffed up tips or remodeling things they can do?
The mistake most people make is they call us and say, can you bring a listing agreement over on the house on the market today? And I go, well, I wish you'd call me a week ago. We need to do the following things. Mm-hmm. We need to spruce the house up. Usually you need to power wash. Usually you need to paint. A lot of times you need to replace carpet. It's like a lady called me the other day. She said, what's my house worth? I said, well, I need to come look at it. She said, well, just give me an estimate. I said, well, how's it decorated? She said, it was professionally decorated. Well, I go over there, it was professionally decorated in 1983.
Gotcha.
That's answering that question.
That was a great year, though. It was a great year.
It was a great year. Yes. And on that note, we'll end it. James, thank you for sharing all about everything.
It's always a pleasure. Always a pleasure.
And to you too, Hannah and LaVon, for all that you shared with us today. And thank you all for watching this episode of 843 TV.
Where communities come to speak.